So the simple way is probably go to your AX application or Dynamics 365 and open new development workspace. I have it already open. And let's assume that we would like to look at the project detail transactions, timesheets plus fees. In application object tree, you have let's say data dictionary tables. If you open this and scroll down, and let's take a look at the project journal transaction table. This table has the information about project journal details, and this table stores timesheets and fees. It is related to project journal table. If you need this table, you can use this one as well. How to get additional information about these tables? Probably the best way is to go to MSDN, Google maybe the table name. For example, project journal transaction table. You will get it immediately there, and you can see the description of this table. As you see, it has hour or fee journals, journal lines. So optionally you can use header table if you like, or you can use just this. Now let's go to the query analyzer. So we will begin with a simple query. Let's take from project table. This is a project table. It's it has cards of each project. You join project table with project journal transaction, bypassing this third table, which you may also need. And the simple join is on project ID equal project ID, but because the same project ID may exist in a different legal entity, you probably join by data area ID as well. Now assume, wait a minute, I just need to extract data from AX and use it as a base for, let's say, something like crystal report or SSRS report, or maybe Power BI report. What do I do? I would recommend you, and you don't have, I assume, development license. So just go to SQL Enterprise Manager, and then just take a look at the tables in Microsoft Dynamics AX database in version 2012 or in Dynamics 365. And you will see the same tables here. And the name is self-explanatory, in my opinion. You will see project journal transaction table, project journal table, as well as all the tables which are intuitively related to this. And now to the same place. Just go to Google and type in the table name. Let's assume that you would start with this. And you would get it in, on MSDN. And this is the query we got with tables joined together. And here is the result of the query. Okay, here is your result. Now let's think that you need something more complex. This is more complicated query where you have also additional tables joined here. As you can see, it's customer table, it's a card for each customer, as well as dear party table. This table has the information about customer name, as well as connection to global logistic postal addresses. And this table, these two tables, they have information about every object, like customer, vendor. Let's take a look at this table. Okay, I have it open here. Dear party table. As you can see, it has all the parties' global address book, in other words. And then this address book does not really have the address itself, so the second table that you need here has addresses. All right, so let's use this query and let's take a look what we got. Now I specially placed the two fields from the addresses, this table. You see valid from, valid to. And as you can see, you have the same line with two different addresses, and the expression of the address is like this. So that's why you have the same line twice. Or maybe you can have more than like three times. And this is due to the fact that the expiration date of the address might be... so you may have several addresses in different moment of time. So what you need to do, you need to complicate this query a little bit. Let me show you what I did here. So you join it either with the address which is current, or use historical address. I use the current address, so I maximize the valid true field and then join it back with this table. So this is artificial additional table. I join it with this table, so to filter out old addresses. So in this case, instead of, let's say, three and a half thousand, you would have less. Let's try it. Okay, so you got only, as you see, 2400. Let's take a look at the script again. So probably the top three tables is probably self-explanatory, but the additional two tables, especially the direct party table, is not. So I mean, probably the best is just to search user groups or Google to get answer on your question. But it shouldn't be a lot of complex links like that. So you should probably take to consideration just a few, and one of them is the party table, which is global address book, and that's where addresses are, this table. And then I used this in Power BI report. So this Power BI report has additional query contract invoices, and it has two pages: summary page and detail page. And from summary page you can go and drill through to details, drill through details, and you'll get details by timesheets and fees for this project, assuming that you are using only this type of costs.